Welcome to today's A Midday Musical Menu Concert. I'm John Deaver, Director of Music at Trinity Episcopal Church in Covington, Kentucky. If you would like a copy of today's program to follow along, it is available on Trinity's website, trinitycovington.org. If you missed earlier concerts of this season, they are still available on Trinity's website under Music and then A Midday Musical Menu. Next month's concert on Wednesday, February 17th, features three organ students from the College Conservatory of Music, a second-year doctoral student, an artist diploma student, and a second-year undergraduate. You will not want to miss their program of Bach, Franck, and Wiehring. It is a pleasure to welcome back the South Bank Quartet in the 40th season of the series. The South Bank Quartet is a string quartet in residence of the Emanuel School of Music in Lakeside Park, Kentucky. The group was founded in 2012. And now Ellen Stevens, cellist, and one of the founders of the group would like to say a few words.
Thank you, Dr. Deaver. It is a pleasure to be here, and we are so thankful to be a part of this outstanding program at Trinity Episcopal Church. I would like to introduce our members here. We, of course, are all members of the Emanuel School of Music, which is a local music school in Lakeside Park, and we are all teachers. So on violin, we have Mr. Evan Hurley. He teaches our Mozart string program to beginning students, our Beethoven strings program, and he also teaches private violin lessons. And also on violin, we have Haley Rudolph. And she also teaches Mozart and Beethoven strings, the concert string orchestra, and the Bartel string ensemble, in addition to teaching multiple private lessons as well. And we have Miss Rebecca Flank, and she teaches violin and viola. And again, she's also a very prominent part in our Mozart and Beethoven string program. I myself, teach cello with the School of Music and directly top two orchestras, the Youth Orchestra and the Youth Symphonia. Today we're going to start our program with Haydn's beloved Sunrise Quartet. We're going to play movement three and four, the last two movements, and I hope you can see our smile of joy under our mask. You'll enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
gotten back to Paris. He had been in Rome for 2 years, and he was definitely looking forward to getting away from the restraints of the academics in Rome and in Italy. So he was very inspired to start going more on his own path of Impressionism and with beautiful tonality and also free form. So it's very expressive and very different as well. So this quartet that we're going to play, Debussy String Quartet, we're going to play the slow movement, which is the third movement. And this was actually one of his first pieces that he wrote after coming back from Rome. So I hope you enjoy the beautiful and different tonality and form. When it always starts with the second violin, sorry about that. And it kind of has a false start, and then again, another false start, and then the movement begins.
Thank you.
American String Quartet. He wrote this quartet when he actually came to America. In New York, they were starting a new conservatory, and they wanted to bring Dvorak as the composer in residence. So he was there for a full academic year, and then in the summer of 1893, he went to a small town in Iowa, Spillville, Iowa, and he spent time in this beautiful place, and he wrote the American String Quartet. And the other famous work that he wrote during that time was also the New World Symphony. So one of his two most famous works. And we will conclude with the finale.
Thank you.